People who know an ecologist will know that you don't ever simply just go for a walk. It normally takes at least twice as long. There's just so much to notice and to look at. You know, for example, I've got here a fallen tree. It's gone down. The tree itself is dead. I mean, you can see this is quite soft, very loose. You'll get beetles that bore into that. They feed on it, have a very long larval stage because it's very hard to break down and get any useful nutrients from this decaying heartwood. You've got all sorts in there. You've got small little beetle holes that I can see in the underside here. There's some here, there's some here. So those are probably where small beetles bored into this and has just basically gone through its life process and emerged as an adult. There's all sorts that goes on in these deadwoods. So although it is deadwood, it's actually alive and bustling. When you're walking through the woods, you might come across a carpet of what looks like white daisies. These are actually an ancient woodland indicator species. You only really get in semi-natural ancient woodlands. They don't colonise new woodlands particularly easily. They're actually called wood anemone, and they're from the buttercup family. Although they're not yellow, they're actually white flowers. And they've got six petals, they have tissue paper thin, the flowers. They're very delicate. And they'll come into flower around sort of April, May time. They're some of the earliest flowering plants in a woodland, and they add a real nice bit of colour to the ground flora in a woodland early on. Here we've got a thick green carpet of wild garlic or Ramsons. And literally, as you step through it and you crush the leaves, break the leaves, it really gives off a smell of garlic. So you know you're in garlic. And it's not in flower yet, although this one is just starting to come out. They're really delicate. They look like your alliums you get in a garden if you're a gardener. And soon enough, this will be a profusion of these sort of pom-pom shaped white flowers. And it's actually got several flowers to each plant. You see one, two, three, four so far. There'll be more where that came from. So when it's fully in flower, oh look, we've got a little beetle on there as well. It's already getting in and collecting probably the pollen, getting the pollen off the plant. There he goes. Okay, so here's a common woodland species that most people will know. It's the bluebell. This is our native bluebell. There is, however, a non-native species, the Spanish bluebell. The easiest way to tell the native bluebell from the Spanish bluebell is that our native plants, the head nods and the flowers all hang one way. You've also got narrower leaves on the native bluebell, and they're more of a purpley colour, whereas the Spanish bluebell is actually a slightly lighter shade of blue. It's really good actually as an early flower species. You often find sort of queen bumblebees as they've just come out of emergence foraging on this, taking the pollen from the plant, which they'll use to rear their first brood of workers. You've got a nice little cluster here of, it's called Moschatel. It's a nice little woodland plant. Another little delicate one. You don't see it everywhere, but it's nice to find when you do see it. So it's got like one, two, three, four. It's like a square face of flowers and then one on the top, and it looks a bit like, I think that's why it's called clock tower or something like that. It looks a bit like Big Ben in the sense that it's got the four faces. Herb Paris, that's a beautiful plant actually. It's got four leaves and a sort of a bulbous flower in the center of it. You get patches of that. You'll just spot patches of it from time to time as you're wandering through a woodland. Some have got loads, some you just get small patches of it. All right, so this is a toothwort. It's a parasitic plant, which is why it's white. It doesn't have any chlorophyll. It gets its energy from tapping into the root systems of hazels and elms and other plants. It comes out early in the year. It's got this sort of these flowers that are thought to look like teeth, hence the name toothwort. The Latin name for this plant actually means secret, and that's because for most of the year you wouldn't know it's there. It's only at this time of year, sort of springtime, around April, May time, when it starts to come out. There's another one just here that's coming through that you actually realise that you've got the plants in the woods.